Kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya. Someone singing, lord, kumbaya. Oh, lord, kumbaya.
Sheikah Baba Bambi Boomba. How? I'll tell you tonight. By the Holy Ghost. You guys want to learn something tonight? How is Native American for already then? Chaga. Glory. Heavy lightning, kavod, breastplate of judgment, glory. Now you're speaking my warring angel love language, Holy Ghost. I thank you for a total incineration of bull crap in this place. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Starting with Jake. Moving on through the crowd, one by one. A human sacrifice. Holy and acceptable to God the Father through fire. Amen. Do you want to be a burnt offering tonight? I do. What else you can do with your life? Serve Satan's? I don't think so. We don't have time for that. We know when the house is on fire. Wow. Ain't nobody got time to serve Satan when your house be on fire in the Holy Ghost. Don't look at me like that. You can look at me any way you want. I'm just in the glory realm enjoying God right now in the Holy Ghost, helping you guys to chill out. You might need some Holy Ghost decaf cappuccinos out there. Go to the ice box, grab yourselves a cold pop. You got time for that. Reevaluate what you're doing with your life. Vice reintroduced my documentary. Over 30 million views. A lot of haters. Some positive people on there, but mostly hate. Pretty wild. The most common thread out of all the dog responses under the sorcerers of Vice and Google, which are the warlocks that run that under the Satans. They have a Luciferian agenda. Very obvious in the Google agenda. Very high level. Luciferian sorcerers of Babylon the Great, of the throne of the Red Dragon, knowingly to manipulate the masses into a diabolical agenda. People are clueless, but they're still under the influence of it. So the most common saying from the Temple of the Dog under the sorceries of Google, which is one of the most diabolical mindsets of all time, called Babylon the Great, was, "We are just waiting for Red Letter Ministries to relapse on drugs." I thought that was interesting. That was the most common response from the Temple of the Dog. It's not something that could pass through my mind or even imagine, but out there, having fun that's healthy is so rare that their unbelief is so strong in them, and I have compassion on them by telling them the truth right now. I know a lot of you people out there are very concerned that we're not compassionate and loving, but you need to be with Moses on the mountain and offer your heart and your feelings as a burnt offering. Because righteousness and the mountain is love that burns with smoke. And if even an animal were to touch it, it'd be stoned to death. Okay? That's New Covenant, by the way. That's New Covenant. That's Hebrews 12. The mountain of the Lord will destroy animal DNA. Animal DNA can't touch it. That's why there's so much mockery. Animal DNA is Homo sapiens sapien DNA. Animal DNA is human DNA. Human DNA can't touch the Holy Ghost. Human DNA cannot touch God the Father's genetics. It tries, it mudflings, it attempts, because unbelief is certain that God is not going to have consequences towards anything of God or the thoughts of God or the ways of God in the earth, because they've watched wickedness have its way their entire life. You know it's true. They watch wickedness have its way their entire life. And so the earth is filled with unbelief, but the temple of the Holy Ghost is the spirit of faith. And your body is that temple if it's a burnt offering tonight. And now we want the temples of faith to rise up in the spirit of truth. God has given you the spirit of truth to lead you. Now, one of the greatest abominations of all time, and people tolerate this stuff and they think it's okay, but Pentecostalism and charismaticism settling for just having the Holy Spirit. We often want to congratulate ourselves in the gifts of the Spirit like we've accomplished something. That's day one in the Bible, people. That's Acts chapter 1. That's day one of Christianity. If you have the Holy Spirit, that is the beginning of rising, because the Spirit of truth will lead you into all truth. There are denominations of literally tens of millions of Pentecostals that think having the Holy Spirit is arriving into the Promised Land. It is the exact polar opposite of that. That mindset is so diabolical. Having the Holy Spirit, Paul says, is a deposit or a first fruit of future glory. So the things of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, is the beginning of Christianity. And it's only Christianity if you let the Holy Spirit continue to lead you every day into more and more truth that the Spirit of God provides as food for the God-sperm part of you, which is your spirit, born again of spirit and water. You've been born again of the Holy Ghost. You've been born again of what? The Spirit of truth. How does the inner man get regenerated? Born again? By the Spirit of truth. Now, you can leave the Spirit of truth. The Bible talks about the spirit of error. There's a spirit of lies. Beelzebub, the father of the spirits that lie. Okay? So you have 200 million spirits down here pretending to be God. All of them call themselves God. To be a demon, you are a false god. To be religion and religious is to serve false gods. So you need to understand, everything is at war for your obedience and sacrifice. For your time and your money, for your blood and your energy, for your DNA. Every spirit in this world, every spirit in this universe needs DNA to operate in. And you are a temple of DNA. But there's only one spirit out of all those tens and hundreds of millions of spirits, only one of them is God. Now that's what the Bible says, and I know every Bible-believing Christian can amen that. But finding that spirit is the beginning of Christianity, and that spirit awakening your heart is the beginning of day one, born again. Now you'll be tested every single day since that day you were born of the Holy Spirit, the one Spirit out of all the spirits in the world that is actually God. And they're all fighting for your DNA. That's why the Bible says he needs your body as a temple of the Holy Ghost. Because your DNA will be influenced by all these other demon gods that are no gods at all, that kill, steal, and destroy from the human blood, drunk on the blood of the saints, the principality, Jezebel, Book of Revelation, and they will do everything they can to manipulate you with lies until the Spirit of Truth leads you, guides you into more truth than you're currently believing in your DNA. Your DNA will follow the Spirit of Truth from glory to glory. But oftentimes, as we know from experience and dealing with millions of people around here, people aren't willing to follow the Holy Spirit anymore. Those who turn back are not worthy of me. Red letters. We think we're worthy, we self-justify. Pride spirits deceive us. And then we turn on the prophets that try to get us to repent, to serve the Spirit of Truth, obey the Spirit of Truth. And that last area where you disobeyed and were disobedient and were unbelieving in your hearts, so that you went into error in the spirit of Babylon and the spirit of the world and the spirits of pride and the spirits of lust and greed and all the other spirits out here that will literally allow you to do anything except obey the Spirit of Truth into higher realms that confront Satan's kingdom. That's why they keep you down. That's why there's a gravity and a pressure, like a black Saturn cube of a kingdom of hell with seven false mountains and a throne of antimony of a counterfeit throne of God through the center of those six mountains to deceive the whole world into a false kingdom of God, into a false kingdom of heaven. There's mystic seers in that mountain. There are a dime a dozen. There are 950 prophets of the red dragon to every one prophet of God the Father around Minnesota right now, around the United States of America right now, around the islands in Europe and Asia, Central and South America right now. You have about 950 voices or people inspired by a seven mountains of seven stars that fell from heaven that are all demons. What did King David say? All their gods are demons. Ah, and they shudder. We're being exposed. That's the whole point of tonight's broadcast. Hallelujah. Come on now. And don't sit out there and tell me the Holy Spirit's your only God. You're a liar. I know your DNA ain't perfect. You're dealing with stuff in your DNA that wants your DNA, especially to oppose the apostolic order of Melchizedek, which is righteousness. And the government of the sun and the government of the moon and the government of the stars and all their light in the order of Melchizedek, which is Jesus Christ's righteousness. Most charismatic DNA right now is opposed to apostolic order and government that comes forth on our watch, on our timeline, the timeline of the gold behind God the Father's throne that is written. There's a manipulation and a delay of times through sorceries, which are religious pride. Sorcery is simply religion. Practicing religion is the highest magic arts, and that's what tempts most of you into false Christianity, into strongholds of demon spirits telling you they're God, and that seven mountains of the seven stars that fell from heaven that's a counterfeit of Enoch's seven stars in Jesus Christ's right hand, the seven archangels that will breathe upon your souls tonight so that you can be delivered from all the powers of the evil one and from all the dominion of the Satans and from all the dominion of sorcery and magic arts that works through the brain. If you've been around warlocks your whole life, and you have, whether you know it or not, they work in your brain. Now, the Holy Ghost is not a warlock. Amen? Truth, anyhow. Oh, deep teaching right there. We can agree with that. Even the Pharisees tune in tonight and be like, now that's sound doctrine, brother. The Holy Ghost is not a warlock of satanic Tartarus imprisonment of satanic hell and witchcraft, and the sewage of the false bride, and the makeup of the counterfeit hypocrite of Satan's whitewashed tomb. Amen, brother. Now you're preaching that Baptist stuff right now. about to have an itinerant ministry down south talking like that in Jesus' name. Whatever, dude. Take your itinerant ministry and shove it where the sun don't shine, which is the Dead Sea, amen? Glory. We're here to bring judgment and order, and it don't matter if anyone's with us. And I know some of you are, and I'm well aware of the ones that are. I'm well aware of the ones on the fence. I want to push you over, do a little cow tipping tonight. Get you through the fence. It's an electric fence, so you're going to die. 3.3 gigawatts. You'll be shot into a different timeline of gold, of glory, of divine light, of light that's truth, which will shred all the other lights operating in you that are just witchcraft. Amen? We want to get people inside the sheep gate, inside the electric lightning fence of fire. One thing that irritates Satan, that there is protection from demons in the earth at every level of Christian maturity. Babies aren't just thrown out into Egypt and thrown down the Nile like Moses to be eaten by crocodiles. They're not just tossed off of high buildings. Babies in Christ are to be grown up in fresh, tender, green pastures. And so you need pastors that are warriors that stand up seven heavens tall to protect sheep nowadays and young lambs and young children in Christ. Now I know you guys got ideas about everything, but just reconstruct them tonight in your brain cells by the heavenly light of the glory that does not lie but loves you, because God is light. In him there is no darkness at all, which means he has no variation of changing his opinion about everything. God never changed. I'm the Lord, I change not. We change. Your mind, your brain is called clay, and God is called potter. He's a master potter, not to be confused with a lot of you people out there, master potheads. Remember what Elijah said? Death is in the pot. Zero THC. Zero. It's sorcery. Repent. Amen. And get into the glory, because you're just totally missing the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. You're destroying your souls on witchcraft and rebellion. Pharmakia, which is any mind-altering drug that does not include sugar or caffeine. For the Pharisees of drugs and alcohol watching right now, because I know who I'm talking to, some of these people are out there, man. And some of you have some sound doctrine when it comes to chemicals. Some of you are just lost, tossed to and fro by every wave of nutritional fact. Can we talk nutrition in the glory? Wisdom. There's spiritual science behind every single principle and law that I'm bringing you tonight from the mountain of the Lord. And we need your heart, your soul, your mind, and your bones, and your marrow to be there. What's the commandment of Moses? Come up the mountain and be there, says the Lord. Come up the mountain and be there. You are welcome on the mountain. Every part of you that God doesn't like, which is sin, will be burnt out of you as a burnt offering. That's why no one approaches God except through fire. Jesus Christ comes to baptize in spirit, regeneration of the inside, and fire, regeneration of the outside. Without both, you'll never see God, period. You need the spirit baptism, and you need the baptism of glory fire for your flesh, for your brain. Big time. Me too. You know, preaching to the choir up here. We need regeneration at a cellular level, an atomic level, at a molecular level. Big words now. Christian chemistry. And this earth is a petri dish, and it's going to be okay. We are winning. Okay? The word of God is indestructible. Everything else will pass away, but the word of God remains forever. If you get the word mixed with your spirit will save your heart and your mind and your bones and your marrow. And your bones and your marrow will change your organs. Because you're going to need your stomach and your pancreas and all your other organs too. And they change. But the bone and marrow is what changes. It's a different DNA. Okay? clearly written in the Bible, Jesus changed his appearance so that nobody could recognize him. That's what scripture says. The changing of appearance, you need this now in your organs. You need this in your bones. You need this in your spirit. You need this update and upgrade and programming of the Word of God. The Word of God is God's genetics. You are born again of the incorruptible seed of the Word of God. Greek word seed, sperma. So what is the sperma of the Father? What's the sperm of God? The Word of God. King of kings and Lord of lords. Come on now. Don't think animal, think angel. You got to keep renewing your minds to speak a higher language with no lust attached. And if there's lust on you, come up the mountain and die and burn. The fire is for cleansing the lust of the eyes and the lust of the flesh so that there's zero lust and you're all virgins. Amen. What does the Bible say? And everyone who rises is a virgin. Wow. It doesn't mean that you're just abstinent because you don't need the Holy Ghost for that. That means you are in union with the same cellular structure of Jesus Christ, the transfigured one. The same cells, brothers and sisters, the same DNA as Jesus Christ, the righteous one. Jesus Christ, the Holy One of Israel. His DNA, drink my blood, what's blood? DNA. Eat my flesh. What's flesh? DNA. So that you will have life in you. Oh, big angel flash. They like that. Woo! Oh, man. Glory. Woo! Signs and wonders. This last week, I had the second largest angel feather I've ever got in my life. The first one, I believe, was from Michael. I believe this one was from Uriel. I have two angel feathers from two of the archangels because they like me and they like you too, maybe. They don't like everyone, you'd be surprised. They love everyone. No, they don't. Sometimes they kill people. Yep, archangels are assigned often to terminate human life. Now let that put the fear of the Lord in you, because you need it. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. You're not just cuddling a teddy bear God. That's a vain imagination. God is all powerful. And if sinners continue sinning, the wages of sin is death. So you think the devil kills people? That's not biblical if you read the Bible. Awfully quiet in here. No, the Bible says the holy angels kill people. That's exactly what scripture says. And I've watched it in RLM before. Now, we of course are not murderers. It's the judgment upon sin that produces death. So when great light comes out of Peter, great sin is exposed in Ananias and Sapphira. They were judged and killed by light confronting darkness. So you want to make sure those that are confident in false light, the light in you is not actually darkness. Because the Hebrews, when they bring false light, selfish, religious, self-righteous light, when they brought it to the true apostolic light of Peter in the Bible, they were killed instantly. So there's a maturity of false light. That's the apostate generation of Enoch. And a maturity of the elect and righteous. That's the true light of the Lamb of God and the God sperm genetics of the Word of God. Hallelujah. You have the maturity of the false kingdom of heaven right now with its false mother of pearl throne that most Christians, most, not the minority, the majority, it is the majority of Christians right now on earth that we love and lay our lives down for that are bewitched by a false seven mountain kingdom. Read Revelation, read the book of Enoch, and unfold mysteries of righteousness. It is clear Satan has counterfeited the charismatic kingdom of heaven. That is the direct civil war of Red Letter Ministries and anyone who's antagonist towards this ministry. Now we have allies. We have pastors that tolerate us. We do. We have prophets that like us secretly. They message me at night. We're not alone up here. People that think that, they'd love to isolate us and get a picture in their mind that we're weak. We are the most connected ministry in the universe. The seven stars are in my spirit's right hand, in my angel's right hand. And I'm only 23 as an angel that uses this temple. And I go in and out of this temple, in and out of the heavens with the archangels every single day. And so will you. It's called normal Christianity, growing up in your spirit. It is something special, and it's special to grow in Christ. It is very, very special. It's the meaning of life. It's the purpose that you were created. It's why you're here. And the Spirit of Truth, your heavenly mother who conceived your spirit, she's called the Mother of Righteousness, the Mother of Spirits, the brooding mother hen. Jesus Christ alluded to the Holy Ghost as his mother. Who is my mother and my brothers and my sisters? Those who do the will of my Father in heaven. Now, we got all kinds of belief systems down here that just don't work. We need to have, like, Book of Acts, witchcraft scroll, book burning, and the amount of scrolls of witchcraft that were burned in that city totaled to $1.4 million. But the witchcraft scrolls that you need to burn, body of Christ, are external words from the false kingdom of heaven. So everything has to be tested in fire. When you test an angel, when you test a prophet, when you test an apostle, people have no problem testing me constantly. It's mostly slander and a little bit test, but they don't know the difference because the church is a mess right now. We need judges. We need Gideon. We need Deborah. We need Samson. We need the 18 judges. We need the last judge, Samuel. We need the judge, Joshua. Amen? And we need the 18 judges and the government of God as judges with thrones of the sun and the moon and the stars in the seven spirits of God before our throne to rule and fix and heal the luminaries, to heal the mid heavens and to heal the earth and to drive this false kingdom of Satan down under the earth into the Dead Sea, which is an abyss of columns of fire prepared for the Satans and their sorcerers who do not repent. So I've seen sorcerers repent. I'm one of them. So I know it's possible. Now, we're used to having dogs repent and then becoming king's kids. Born of God's royal seed line. Amen? We're not used to maturing that seed line into royalty that's more royal than King Charles and the 13 crown royal families of Europe that are worth trillions of dollars. Trillions. We're not used to real royalty. We have a spiritual make-believe royalty that only works in Satan's false kingdom of heaven, whose throne goes all the way up to the top of the mid-heavens and looks in appearance to the greatest seer of all time, Enoch, to be the throne of God. And the archangel had to tell him that's not the throne of God. The archangel told him that's the throne of Lucifer. This is why you have such confusion in charismatic Christianity. You have people literally with millions of followers from Morningstar Ministry, Lance Walno, teaching the seven mountain mandate. Is it the seven mountains of the kingdom of heaven that go up into the seventh heaven? Mixture. I believe sometimes there is allusion to that. But from my experience in dealing with Morningstar Christians that I love Rick Joyner. You know, we talk about his books constantly. You need to read them. I'm telling you now, there's a maturity of the apostles and prophets, teachers, evangelists, and pastors into a much more... Bobby Connors with Morningstar. He lives in Moravian Falls. Come on now. But I'm telling you now, understanding the two different mountain ranges of the seven and the seven. The seven spirits of God is the mountain range of the seven mountains of God that goes up into the seventh heaven. which means any born again Holy Ghost prophetic believer that does not know God's Holy Spirit as the seven spirits of God recreating and mothering their spirit is going to be on the false seven mountains of the seven stars that fell from heaven. These seven mountains, Enoch the archangel explained as he breathed on them. These seven mountains, Enoch, are the seven mountains of the prison of the stars that fell from heaven, and whose throne is as the throne of God, and it goes up to the heights of heaven. Now that's what the archangel said, and the greatest seer of all time, your father Enoch, whose generations you're a part of in the tree of life, couldn't tell the difference until the archangel explained it to him. Now, if it's that deceiving to the greatest seer who's ever lived, who saw this generation 4,500 years ago, do you think the Christians today in their current state are going to have discernment of what seven mountains they're seeing dreams and visions and are being inspired from? Look at the condition of the American church. It's natural. A lot of times it's very political. Be wary of the seed of Herod, politics. Now there's teaching on that. God wants you in kingdom politics. Heavenly Sanhedrin is kingdom politics, infants in Christ. But there is a Sanhedrin that is a counterfeit of Christian born-again conservative politics that is diabolical. We need discernment, which is wisdom, to save our lives. We need leadership that can see like Enoch in these days. What does Jesus Christ say in the New Testament, in the book of Revelation? I counsel you. Are we going to receive the Lord Jesus' counsel tonight? Yes, Brandon, we shall receive the Lord Jesus' counsel tonight. Good. Jesus counsels you to buy eye salve so that you can see. And it does go on the eyes, so the eyes flash with fire. You're looking at Jesus' flesh eyes that are perfectly consumed by his spirit eyes, and his spirit eyes have so burnt through his heart and his brain that they're on the outside before his throne. That's God the Father, people. Who's the greatest in the kingdom? Servant of all. That's why the Father is before the throne of his Son, Jesus, in Revelation chapter 4, because the Father is greater than the Son, Jesus Christ said in the red letters. The Father is greater than I. Truth, anyhow. The Father's greater than me. The Father's greater than you. Always will be. I'm happy about it. That's original design, to have a great almighty Father. Come on, people. Now the Holy Ghost is the down payment of your heavenly Father. It's just the down payment. He is testing you in fire to see which kingdom you'll be loyal to. And after you get the down payment, do you develop the seven spirits of God, the God sperm seed of the Word of God that had the container of the anointing in it, and develop it into a state of maturity where there's nothing else in you except the Spirit of Truth, which is the living Word, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. King of Kings! Lord of Lords! And he's coming with the shout of the archangel. Whoop! Yeah. And a silver trumpet. Where are you going to get the silver trumpet? In the dead part of you. The part of you that's still irritated with strife towards your apostolic leadership. When we judge ourselves mature in different areas, when we're not actually in the seven spirits of God, when we're not in union and intimacy with the Spirit of God, and we're in disobedience to the Spirit of God, but we have self-justified through religious spirits to our own destruction. See, God wants to be your justifier. The cross and his blood is your justifier. If anything else is justifying your spirit, your soul, your feelings, your emotions, your mind, your past, your present, future, you're not forgiven of your sins because your own animal blood is your justice. You need blood that's not animal. Animal blood doesn't forgive sins, people. The blood of God, the righteous one, forgives sins. In the spirit, those who sin in the spirit, it'll work in your spirit and cleanse your bowels. Cleanse your treasure house so that your God, which is your stomachs, can be a spiritual God named Jesus Christ. Because by default, when you are infants and young in the Lord, your stomachs are your God. That's where selfishness comes from. That's where lust comes from. your spirit, your own spirit, leads you astray. That's what the Bible says. Yeah. Your own spirit leads you astray. But until God's spirit has conquered your spirit by constantly being a burnt offering, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable on the mountain of Isaac. Isaac is the place of dealing with idolatry, and the biggest idol is self. And until self, spirit, your own spirit, your own feelings, your own heart, your own mind, your own thoughts, and your bones and marrow, which is the will of your life on earth, is constantly conquered, not one time, constant. The baptism of fire, which is what this process is, constantly conquers your spirit so you don't sin in the spirit, your soul so you don't sin in the soul, your mind so you don't sin in the mind, your bones so you don't sin with your bones in your will doing some other spirit's will in the garden. We need to do the will of God the Father who sent us. You're all sent because you're born again. If not, just ask Jesus in your heart, be recreated. Say, come Holy Spirit in your heart and recreate me. And some of you need to get your spirit back under the order of righteousness, because your spirit, you believe some kind of demon that your spirit can now do whatever you want because your spirit's perfect. That's not what scripture says. And that's not what I've taught. You've misunderstood my teachings, because I teach in part in the whole collective of months and months and months of the entire picture. You can't take an hour and a half to get the full understanding of wisdom. It'll take the whole year of 2022 to put it together to be the whole loaf of bread. Don't come in here, have one slice of bread, and say, oh, I got it. You're totally deceived. You need the understanding of the ages, the wisdom of the ages, and each Joel's bar is a slice of the wisdom of the ages. If you take that slice and make it the whole bread, you will guaranteed serve the fallen angels, because you've rejected all the other stuff that's inconvenient to your own selfishness. That's how spirits begin to sin in the spirit, which many of you listening to me, because you're young Christians, began sinning in the spirit. Because you take truths and you use it in your spirit without the whole loaf, which is the Father's house, and submitting your spirit under the 1,000-pound white ox, which is the name of the Lord of Spirits in Scripture. Truth anyhow. So we want to completely disciple all the rebellion underneath the Spirit of Truth, because then you can actually grow and then you'll see results. But if your spirit's out of the order of righteousness, your soul's out of the order of righteousness, which is the law of righteousness, and your mind is in Timbuktu, and we don't even know where your mind is right now, and your bones and marrow are just excited to pass your test to get out of Minneapolis, you will never grow in Christ. You need to be discipled under God. What does the Bible say? They shall all know God. And the word know is yada, which is intimate knowledge. Same word used in Ephesians 1:16, that you may have the spirit of wisdom and revelation of intimate knowing of the Father of glory. And it has 0% anything sexual with daddy. You need your innocence restored so you can say daddy and not be immoral in your thought life. There is a cleansing unto virginity of Jesus Christ, the spotless lamb, in your minds from all the smut of Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Pornhub, internet, and all the decadence of all the societies under the sun. It's American society. Listen, I'll just tell you, one of our missionaries told us he went to go get a back massage when he was in Nairobi. And he said, Brandy, you're not going to believe this. She started rubbing my penis as I was trying to get a back massage to get all of the kinks out of my back in Nairobi. And he was just totally blown away, and it just cursed him. The sexual morality is horrendous everywhere, because immorality of lust spirits is the guaranteed contract before the holiness of the Father that this person is not allowed to go higher in the Holy Spirit. They hold up contracts. There are courts. There are accusations. There are courts at every degree and level of holiness and glory. And they can use scrolls of your actions and the recordings of your words and your contracts of your words and your deeds, even if you're sinned against, they can hold it up. And even if they're the ones who did the sinning against, I'm sure that woman is demon-possessed. The missionary had good intentions. He was violated by a masseuse, and he wanted just the knots worked out because he had terrible back pain. It's like going to the doctor, people, and the doctor is hot, and she starts rubbing your cock. And that happened to me when I was in Teen Challenge when I was 18 years old. Jezebel is always setting traps to try to ensnare boys and girls to stain their innocence along the way, because it's the guaranteed contract where you can't go higher in the spirit if they have an accusation of lust upon you, even if you think you're innocent. You have to deal with the accuser of the brethren who accuses the brethren night and day. Even though, oh yeah, we all come out of total depravity. What did Kurt Cobain say? Everyone's a whore. Yeah, it's true. You're born a whore. You could be born a Queen Elizabeth. You're born whores. King Charles is a whore. There's no purity in human DNA, and so the devils use that to accuse you night and day, and we have a religious argument. It doesn't stand with the angels. It's garbage, and it's just dog throwing mud upon dog in the mud. It's dogs playing in the mud. In order to have an argument that wins against the Satans, listen now, as a person who's probably the most accused person of your whole generation, me, this is how you win against the Satans in the realm of the angels who accuse you night and day. You come with the scroll of the word, you do confess your sins and you are forgiven, but you come with the greater word. And that word has to be in your angel, and the angel will go through the heart and the blood, and it will go through the elevation of the ascension of the inner man, being like, nope, here's the scripture. I have a right, a legal right, as a child of God to be at this elevation. Yes, I screwed up in the past, but my past is forgiven, and the word of God has cleansed my past. They will try to stain you for things in your conscience that the Spirit has already applied the word to. So some stuff is just a seared conscience. Some stuff is a real accuser. Some stuff is strongholds and altars and high places of the kingdom of hell and its seven mountains and the throne of the red dragon. What does the Bible say? The red dragon accused the saints night and day. That's how his throne and his kingdom remains intact in the second heavens. It's through accusation of the saints. Beware that your mouth isn't a part of that kingdom now. Come on. You ain't going to make it if you are. You'll be destroyed with the fallen angels if you're a part of the accuser's kingdom. And that doesn't mean we don't judge the wickedness out of ourselves and others. It's just constant cleansing unto purity. White garments, the righteous acts of the saints. You're going to deal with this stuff. You'll deal with immorality at a genetic level. You're not just dealing with memories like, well, I was good in my past. I'm 70 years old and I never had sex with a man. You still go to hell. Okay? You still go to hell. It's not about the outward actions. It's the inward actions of the heart. God sees the heart. It's the development of the inner man in the purity, in the virginity of Jesus Christ. And the inner man cleanses the outer man to be the exact likeness of the Son of God. Of these ones he's not ashamed to call brothers and sisters. And I understand your level of maturity out there, that this is very, very technical, surgical ground in dealing with your lust that's often hidden under religion. Okay? And there is often lust that pretends to be love even in marriages. And God will glorify your marriages. And so there's so much confusion around sexuality in the marriage covenant, Satan and the lust spirits and all this junk. And this is probably the most confused area, if you look at this generation, of all time. They try to confuse their sexuality now at birth. We don't even want to say if it's a boy or a girl. That's a common argument amongst millions of people on planet Earth right now. We want them to choose their own gender. Right? You guys understand that's what's going on with millions and millions of people right now on the planet? A confusion of sexuality to the point where it corrupts all humanity, and the only reaction we have in the dirt is a religious argument against the Satans who pervert sexuality. Then we self-justify and condemn the lawless and the wicked while we're still on earth, and it's not a righteous judgment. Righteous judgment is God the Father's light of the laws of the luminaries that judge it when righteousness is formed in your inner man. It's cosmic versus earth, dirt. It's dust versus stars. And the stars do not belong to the Satans. They're the thieves of their light who corrupt the laws of the luminaries. As it is written in Enoch, the righteous will restore and heal the luminaries. Now, what does that mean? I thought you said that the stars' DNA are perfect. They are, but outside the stars and the city gates are the sorcerers, it is written. Which means you can pervert the light of the sun and the stars from a distance and glean its heat and its energy and its light with no obedience to the law or the name or the deed of that star that bears God the Father's name and image in it. That is the difference between the tree of Satan in the garden. And really, the tree of Satan in the garden is not what you think it is. It's seven mountains that have the appearance of the kingdom of heaven. The seven mountains that have the appearance of the kingdom of heaven is what we're at war against. And if I can get 300 soldiers listening. Now, we do have disciples here. We have people heavily involved with all of their house, in this house, like Moses on the mountain. We have people heavily evolved all over the planet, okay? We say we're a small ministry, but it does influence every single soul on this planet. The higher you go up, the more influence you have down. There is not a single being or creature that breathes that's not influenced by this group. Is it Red Letter Ministries? Yes, it is the Red Letter Ministry. It is also the kingdom of heaven and the true seven mountains. And anyone not against us is for us in the same apostleship of Jesus Christ. Same exact thing today. If they're not against us, they're for us because we're an all-consuming fire. This is Zion. This is the seven mountains of God that go up by the seven spirits of God through the human spirit, which is the sheep gate to the Father, which is what? Worshiping God in spirit and in truth. What's the other thief and robber, people? In soul and truth. Whoa, look at that now. Spirit and truth is what Jesus Christ said in the red letters, which is how we worship God, sheep gate to the Father, spirit and truth. Most of these people that have 100 million different gods and just experience Red Letter Ministries as one of the spiritual things they put into their spirituality, which you're dealing with in this Babylonian generation. You're dealing with Babylon, which was, we accept everyone. Well, clearly they do not. Clearly they do not. Why? Because this is the end of Babylon the Great. You're not in the midst of Babylon. Some of you are tasting the tip of the mountain that's above Babylon and are having a perspective of the great white eagle over Babylon of Jesus Christ and God the Father. Keep those eagle eyes. It's invaluable. It's priceless. The maturing in the gifts in the higher levels are priceless. We're for the gifts. All of us here will operate in all the gifts. It's using them to destroy the kingdom of Satan. Why does God give gifts to men? The Son of Man is made manifest to destroy the works of the devil. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and he went around doing good, destroying all the power of the evil one. It is written, the gifts from Father God are for the destruction of Satan's kingdom that has the likeness and appearance of charismatic perfection. This ain't going to be obvious to even the most skilled prophets coming out of Bethel and Morningstar. You are challenged. I've dealt with you by the dozens and by the hundreds for 15 years. We're not new to this. People from Morningstar, Bethel, John Paul Jackson's ministry have all come through this house. Jeff Jansen's ministry, all the glory stream has mingled with me, mostly secretly, and then sometimes have found fault with us with shock prophetics that they can't ever do in their churches. They'd lose everyone. We can do that out here in the wild, wild west. Because I don't have to submit to Robert's rules of order and all the people-pleasing stuff to keep the sheep inside the shed. When you're on the front lines, it's a little bit different. Like my dad said in Vietnam, killing a murder charge in Vietnam was like a speeding ticket back in the States. You're killing anyone, they're killing their own soldiers, people. My dad was aware of friendly fire. They killed, and there's no charges. Okay? So when you're, I'm not justifying murder. I'm telling you, when you're on the front lines of Joel's army for real, there's different rules in the heat of battle. And it's, you know, scraping. It's combat wrestling to the death against spirits that a lot of people back with the stuff and with the junk back at home, back in the easy places that aren't challenged in their belief systems, aren't challenged in their Christianity constantly. You don't have the ability to cling to those things when your life is being constantly threatened by sorcerers and their demon gods in a real system that wants to kill you. I've been shot at over 20 times since I've been in full-time ministry. They tried to kill me at point-blank range my first week of full-time ministry. I've told the story many times. Down here on Chicago and Lake Street, in front of Sonny's, I was leaving a Bible study at Christ Church, Assemblies of God Church, and five gangsters came up right to my car, pushed the kid's head down right outside my window, less than 10 feet from me, emptied a clip into his brain, blew his brains out right in front of me. And the gun was pointed directly at me through the kid's brain. And the Holy Ghost says, this is what full-time ministry is going to be like for you. I said, well, I'm glad I had a Vietnam vet father. I grew up in a foxhole. I can handle it. And it's been carnage like that ever since! It's been awesome. It's been life and death. It's been very wild. Lots of threats of dying. Lots of chaos. Woo, buddy. But lots of victories. I am so thankful for this calling. I wouldn't have it any other way. But the first week, God warned me. Full-time ministry is not going to be like being a youth pastor in the Assemblies of God. It's going to be like being a forward observer in the Marine Corps in Vietnam during the Tet Offensive. Okay? So that's the warning. First week, 2006. So I go into it in Little Mogadishu in the West Bank for 2 years, 8 hours a day of prayer, 8 hours a day of studying the Word, 8 hours a day of revelating with my angels, to 8 hours every single night in Cedar Riverside, where there's the highest concentration of crime in Little Earth, which is the only inner city Native American reservation in the United States of America. And at that time had the highest crime rate of any place in the USA. And they showed me the stats, not boasting, not making it up. It was the most diverse area, Phillips neighborhood, you can Google this, 156 languages spoken in one neighborhood. 156 languages spoken in Phillips neighborhood, Minneapolis, Minnesota, as a refuge city for all the immigrants of the entire planet for the last 50 years. The Somalian gangs, the organized crime, the gangs, the pushing, the poverty, the desperation was so extreme that was the training of the foundation of the first 2 years from 2006 to 2008. Carjacked twice. I had a gang leader come at me with a Bowie knife. True story. He was a leader of a gang. He was a patched member of a biker gang. And they were known to be major heroin distributors in the region. This isn't just a joke. This is life and death. He came at me with a Bowie knife. Everything went into slow motion. I went into the spirit just like Jesus did, and he passed through the midst of them. That happened to me in 2006 as a Bowie knife was going towards my belly. And this demon-possessed gang leader wanted to murder me. And I stepped over in slow motion, he actually lunged in slow motion right next to me as I'm turned to the side, looking at the Bowie knife go past me. Woo! Tried to get me right in my guts and kill me. Awesome stuff. And then I praised the God of Israel, who had dominion over the elements to put everything into slow motion so that I didn't die in the first 6 months of full-time ministry. Isn't that awesome? And because Satan tried to kill me, his second in charge of that organized crime syndicate came and got delivered from heroin and lived in my house for 6 months, and I discipled him. That happened in 2006 and 2007. True story. Those were the foundations of Red Letter Ministries. We're an inner city missionaries for years and years and years. Been doing this now for like 16 years. Okay? We're veterans of warfare in the urban environment of the USA at the highest level of organized crime. We've dealt with everything that exists in society. You can just feel that stuff. You haven't done. We have dealt with everything that exists in this society. We have. And we have learned through constant combat and experience what works and what doesn't. You need this understanding when you come into this mighty house, that you are not coming into a house of suggestions, opinions, or possibilities, but of rock solid iron of Zion tested and true. And if it doesn't work, we don't believe it. If it does work, we believe it, and we'll grow in the working of that word like gemstone in the true seven mountains rising in our hearts as government over all the earth. In Jesus' name. So the fake, fluffy belief systems of most people coming out of the charismatic church that aren't facing the deepest darknesses and the deepest secrets of Satan on a street level in the USA, all of that stuff is animal opinions. That's what's wrong with you. That's why the demons are relentless to turn you against me. I'm coming from combat experience on the front lines for 16 years. Most of you can't relate to 1% of my life. And it's not that you need to, it's that you have to learn from actual wisdom, which is costly at a death level. Wisdom kills. A love that's stronger than death. A love that scorns and shames death. The blood of Jesus, the nails of the cross, the seven piercings of Christ, Calvary, Zion, the true seven mountains, the throne of the Lamb, the throne of the Father, the wisdom of the angels, the wisdom of the ancients, the wisdom of God. All the wisdom has to be formed in the real deal against the false by the seven spirits of God boiling your souls off of your spirits. Do you want to know what's wrong? Why there's so much contradiction, why there's so much opinionation, why it's 99.99% of charismatic believers tune in and are offended from actual wisdom and combat experience in full-time ministry against warring against the highest level sorcery of Babylon the Great and the Scottish Rite and the 32nd degree Freemason warlock and the 32nd degree daughter of the Eastern Star warlock of the United States of America and the United Kingdom, and Europe, and Australia, New Zealand, and every other nation has their own system of sorcerers. Russia is Freemasonry as well. Moscow is also Freemason. Switzerland, Freemason. Germany, as Freemason as Adolf Hitler gets. You are going up against organized sorcery. And it is so intense and perfected all the way to the gates of the third heaven. I've been to the throne of the red dragon. I have seen Pan. I have seen Moloch. I understand Satan's kingdom from angelic experience. And God has allowed my mind to go with my soul, to go with my 23-year-old, nine-race, angelic Yahweh spirit to see these places and to experience these things in reality with no fantasy, like Enoch. We're getting there. We will be like Enoch at a level of perfection in the years to come. And it's only years away. It's not decades a year away, it's only years away. This is the path of righteousness that does shine ever brighter until what? The full brightness of God the Father in your spirit. And your flesh goes clear, and your DNA goes clear, and the accusation and the arguments against your righteousness and electness and chosenness and holiness is annihilated into the Dead Sea under the earth. And Satan the accuser no longer shall accuse them because they're vindicated in the heavenly luminaries and the heavens are healed. What is the healing of the luminaries? The end of accusation against the elect and chosen and righteous. The end of accusation against Brandon Barthrop and Red Letter Ministries. When that happens, then the elect and righteous and holy will have vindicated the heavens, and the luminaries in the heavens are healed. That is the exact measurement and timeline for this whole universe. Truth anyhow. Truth anyhow. So you can see with the reintroduction of vice, woo! We should have favor with those people. Their brains are penetrated by the Satans to fight the people who love them and care for them the most. Madness is attacking the people who love you. You've done it. You often do it to me. Attacking the people that care for you as God the Father cares for you is the animal's madness in their mind, the influence of Satan, the influence of sin. Guys, this is the majority of the reactions of people's minds and people's hands, their brain, their mind, their hand, their will, their body, their temple. In the reaction to those who care for you the most, it's usually negative, like rebellious children towards a perfect father. Above the sun is perfection. You know that? Not just in spirit, but in soul and in mind and in word and in body. Truth anyhow, in DNA. Truth anyhow. Be perfect as your Father in heaven's perfect. Wow. Well, you can do that physically in the perfect covenant. Don't self-justify. There's no excuses for anything. It's a lack of revelation of what's available that my people perish, it is written. God the Father is going to so prepare a feast for you of the Lamb of God that it will annihilate the corruption in your spirits, in your souls, in your minds, and in your bodies. God won't live in a corrupt body. Are you insane? God lives in your spirit because your spirit, that part where you believe the word, not all of it, but the part where you're in faith, because you have to grow in faith for your whole spirit to be transfigured. Your whole spirit's not transfigured. Not at all. Most of your spirit's in rebellion. In rebellious spirits, lust spirits, pride spirits. Truth anyhow. But your spirit's perfect in the area where you're obedient to God's word. Now, maturity is full obedience with your whole spirit. When your whole spirit consumes then your soul. And then it consumes your mind. And then it consumes your bones. That's when your spirit is obedient to the Father. That's when your spirit is a righteous spirit. And what does Enoch say? When your spirit is a, exact words written, holy spirit. Jesus sent his Holy Spirit. When are you going to send your Holy Spirit down to the underground? So you don't end up like a clown with a frown by looking around town. But you've ascended on the mountain and you've learned to be there. Come up the mountain and be there, which is maintain that elevation on the inside by practicing rigid righteousness, practicing the sun and its lightnings, practicing the pathway of fire and the lightnings that come out of the stars and suns of fire that you walk through. I had a silver sign today. Rebecca had a gold sign. Spirit is symbolized by silver. Soul is symbolized by gold. We had both spirit sign and soul sign of supernatural silver and gold today. And the silver appeared on my perfume book as I was making the perfumes. Thank you for everyone that took advantage of the Black Friday sales. They're over with now. But we had 33 purchases It was the most business I've ever done in my entire life. Wow. Thank you. It was wonderful. And I enjoyed perfuming for you, even though it was like 100 bottles. It was wild. But today, as I was perfuming, silver literally materialized under a fragrance. I didn't sell a single one of these. So there might be oil on some of you buying this fragrance because the angel put the silver under the fragrance called Fire Rose. And Fire Rose is red, which is Jared and the next castle of holiness that Rebecca and I are stepping into as king and queen of all Israel. Truth in you, by the seven spirits of God and the will of God the Father who sent us to be your deliverers. And we want you all to be delivered, especially from strife, when you react to statements like that that the demons in you think are pride. You need to be able to be confident in who you are in Christ. It's not pride, it's humility. Humility is being confident in who your angel is in Christ. False humility is not even knowing who your angel is in Christ and just kind of put yourself down or something. See, the problem is you're only something in spirit. The flesh counts for nothing. The flesh will follow spirit. The soul will follow spirit as you're being fathered by the Father of spirits. Then in your spirit, you'll be of God's race, which is his chosen race, Israel, the 144,000. Then you become real Jews. Romans 2, don't look at me like that. Circumcised of heart, Apostle Paul, scripture. Who are true Jews? Those circumcised of soul. Holy Ghost. My body needs to catch up to my spirit right now. I'm so excited that my DNA can't even follow my angel's genetics. But I'm so thankful to be able to communicate mysteries to you. Hallelujah. Glory. Lord, help these people DNA be cleansed and let their spirit be built up tonight. See, you burn the animal as the animal sacrifice, which is your human DNA, the new covenant, in the fire of the Holy Ghost. But then your spirit gets built up, and now God prepared a body for you with perfect DNA. That's why you'll be young at 100. You'll outlive Methuselah. It's not just possible. We're teaching the spiritual science of Scripture how it's done. The overcoming of death is a teaching. It's not a mystery. It's a teaching. It's a knowledge. It's an illumination. It's a righteous understanding of the Holy Spirit and his word's ability working in the new creature in Christ. Your new creature in Christ is often pummeled by demons through your brain, suppressing you through your human blood. That's why people just get crushed when they come around and then they're not serious enough to ascend and develop the God sperm genetics and their angel of the Yahweh kind. Sons of God are Yahwehs. Clearly written in the word, have I not said you are gods? And you're not going to die as men because you're not going to be men anymore. And you're not going to be women anymore. You're going to be angels. God created them angels in the first, but through knowledge, they are perishing. It is written. Come on. That's bad knowledge there. We want the spirit of knowledge here. What's the Holy Ghost's name? Isaiah 11:2. Isaiah chapter 11, verse 2. What is the spirit of grace's name? The spirit of knowledge. So we just want to dumb our head and act like stupid drunks, act like dope heads. God wants to get you intelligent here because acting like a fool is not rewarded. That's when you're in the lowest part of God as a fool for Christ's sake. There's no rewards for that. If you stay like that, it turns into a pig's pen. That's why half the drunken glory is just totally backslidden serving male Jezebels in the wrong kingdom entirely, just living like pigs. It's because they don't understand. Understanding and knowledge is the seven spirits of God pastoring your spirit up. If your brain latches onto a manifestation, and that's what the manifestation of maturity looks like, now you have to drink. Drinking his blood is the new covenant. You can't stop it. His blood isn't this pig's blood. It's not rat's blood. It's not earth's blood. It's the blood of the third heaven. So make sure you're going up into the third heaven through the second heaven. Otherwise, you're drinking demons. And that's what's wrong with half of you. You're drinking the wrong cups. You're toking the wrong ghost. It's like the ghost of Christmas future. Nasty. Well, it's slothfulness, and it's black sun, and it's black moon, and it's a lack of God's nature entirely, and it's the antimony and that makeup of Jezebel that mixes and tells you it's God, self-inspiration, which is soul inspiration. She who calls herself a prophetess. I don't call myself a prophetess. God calls me a prophet. Truth in you. And if you agree with God, you're in a majority of one. The difference between Jezebel and Elijah, Jezebel and me, is that my inspiration comes from my spirit. Her inspiration comes from her soul. She calls her soul a prophetess, which is the self nature. I fight the soul as an animal sacrifice, as a mark of a beast, every single day in this broadcast since 2009 when Joel's Bar started. We are 3 years into full-time ministry already, doing inner city missions at the most hardcore level in U.S. history. More than even Teen Challenge with the gangs of New York City. Because that was the inspiration, and of course, everything is built upon. So we are doing greater works than New York City organized crime and the foundation of Teen Challenge in New York for 3 years. Because I signed up for it. With all the deaths and the murder and the mayhem and the chaos and constant stuff that you deal with in the lowest places of society in the USA, amongst all the immigrants. It's true. So the experience was building upon what the previous generations of apostles and prophets, David Wilkerson, have done. If you're not doing greater works, then you're not in the correct tree of life. It's true. If I'm not doing greater works than Bob Jones, I'm a false prophet. If I'm not doing greater works than David Hogan, then I'm a false apostle. What are greater works? Enoch ruling with the luminaries, being of the heavenlies and not the earthlies. And we're doing the greater works. And it'll be proved to you also, you who doubt in your hearts and minds. Greater works of the sons of God are cosmic. They're sovereign. The workers at the end of the age are stars, their laws, their names, their deeds, and their angels. It is written. The workers at the end of the age are the angels. Well, somebody is going to enforce angels that are in their posts, obeying their orbit and their courses of their constellations in the heavenlies, and heal the luminaries and bring down all their star power, which is the enforcement at a DNA level on Earth, and all their angel power, which whacks the demons behind the corruptions. And therefore, all the kingdom of Satan in its false seven mountains of the false charismatic kingdom of heaven and the false throne of God that is of antimony and not of mother of pearl will be destroyed into the Dead Sea. Not in the earth anymore, down under the earth, in a dead sea, prepared for Satan and his angels and all the men and women and children that don't repent from sin. Truth anyhow. Men, women, and children will go down there. Some of them alive like Dathan. Now, some of you out there don't have a stomach for it because you're too immature. You'll get one in the days ahead. God will give you a righteous stomach. God will give you a holy stomach. To stomach the things of judgment that you're too immature to believe in right now because of the Laodicean curse on your minds of false love. Love that's under the sun, which is diabolical, which is sympathy towards the fallen angels inside men and women's flesh. Truth in you? So you're not going to have sympathy for the devil. You're not going to have sympathy for sin. You'll have a righteous and holy spirit and a righteous and holy angel that will actually war with the stars like Deborah in Judges 5:20, and the stars warred for Deborah against Sisera, who is Satan. It is written, the stars from their orbit will orbit through the ephod of your spirit, through your righteous spirit, and through your holy spirit, and the sun will pass through the 12 gates of your spirit, and the moon, who is equal in size, will pass through the 12 gates of your righteous ephod, through the 12 portals of every one of you of the royal chosen race of Jesus Christ. Because you have an ephod of a breastplate of 12 portals in your spirit if you grow in spirit and not in Jezebel, which is soul, which is why half of you are still at strife against me. Because you're developing the wrong part of you. You're developing the satanic part of you, soul. You need to develop the God sperm part of you, spirit. And then offer your soul as a beast and an animal to God's spirit, to the seven torches burning in your spirit and their word daily in order to be basic disciples of the true kingdom of heaven. That's like level one discipleship. That's level one. The first level is you have no other gods besides me in spirit and in truth, which is your whole spirit submitted to the seven spirits of God as your master, the master of the force. Yeah, as your father Yoda, and all of you are little Grogu's with your 20-pack chicken nuggies, special treat, frog-flavored cat food with spiders hanging out of his little mouth. Mandalorian season 3 comes out in February. If it's not prophetic, we might have to just judge Disneyland and Disney World into the Dead Sea. This is their last chance. Sick and tired of these pedophiles. The Luciferian agenda of the sorcerers of Babylon the Great is coming to an end. I'm very impressed with Elon Musk. That's not saying much. But how he's waged war against the deep state in many ways has joined the free people of Earth. Now they're animals. They're not doing it as angels, but they're doing it as Ishmael. That's Ishmael. Elon Musk is in Ishmael company. Understand prophetic divine wisdom of the scriptures. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Isaac's brother, Ishmael, Hagar's son, was sent out and given water, and the angel of the Lord blessed him. But he was sent out. It's not the chosen race. Chosen race is spirit race. But the soulish people doing the right thing, eating off the tables of the chosen race of spirit, which is us and those like us around the planet that don't know us yet, but we'll meet up in the spirit in the future because we are one. The ones that are eating off of our royal race's table and are still doing the right thing, that are now influenced by the cosmic tree of life and not Satan's kingdom in the second heavens pretending to be the tree of life. These ones out there, they have joined us in many ways, like Ishmael. They're the ones doing the natural work while we do the angelic work. Doesn't mean you reward them. They're still unbelievers. Elon Musk has 13 wives and like 13 kids with 13 different women. I mean, there's no justification of behavior, but my God, look at Trump. Look at Elon Musk. Look at Kanye West. Look at even Eminem has joined them, people. Eminem even professes Jesus Christ to be his Lord and Savior now. There is a movement that's being squelched by the diabolical media, and it comes from the underground. They even try to quench us on Facebook, on YouTube. They stifle our numbers. They stifle our voice, even in the Vice documentary. There is a diabolical matrix to confuse the mind in an agenda that brainwashes people. And we expose it. It's the matrix, but it's also simply called potent sorcery. We demystify all the sorceries of the Satans, and there's no sorcery in God. God is righteousness. Righteousness might look like sorcery. Paul kept scrolls around him, wore like a monk's garb, and went around. You see him coming and what he could do, you'd probably think he was the greatest warlock of all time, and he was often accused of that. I mean, he looks like some kind of witch. But he came around, it was just pure righteousness, and he'd blind sorcerers and warlocks, darkness and shadows. He'd raise the dead, drive out demons, cat. And so the enemy has counterfeited even what the apostolic looks like. It looks like Gandalf the White times a trillion. It really does. And every single one of you has the opportunity to grow up in the ancient magic, in the true wizardry of God. And to repent and destroy all the false sorceries that the manipulations of Molech, Pan, and the Red Dragon. The Red Dragon's magic spells deceived the whole world. That's what Revelation says. So magic arts, it is a mixture of starlight in human DNA. But it's outside the stars. And so paranoid schizophrenic Christians down on Earth, they just reject God created the stars and their hosts. They just reject the whole book of Enoch. They call Enoch diabolical as they go to their Freemason pastor churches that are practicing false Kabbalah right over their heads, satanic Kabbalah right over their heads, and just one out of three pastors in Australia right now is a practicing Freemason, men and women, and the U.S., same statistics, in all first world nations. You have professionally trained diabolical satanic Kabbalists, which is the manipulation of starlight and human DNA, running Christianity. And the Pope is really what influenced it and turned Christianity into what it is today in the West. Of 350 AD and 500 AD, they corrupted and they changed the times and the seasons. It became an organized religion. It came into Sunday, Star Day, and it was always Saturday was the Sabbath. It became Sunday was the Sabbath. They changed the times and the seasons. Constantinople, and he saw a vision of all this stuff. And there was mixture in that, and God used some of it for good, but it was mostly a mixture of paganism. And we know the Charismatic Church, they study that. That's why we have Harvest Fest instead of Halloween now, because like now everybody knows that. I mean, we teach that in all of our good charismatic churches. But what they don't teach is the roots of sorcery involved in soulish Christianity, what we teach. And you see them weeping and gnashing their teeth in all charismatic Christianity against us in the next level of deliverance from the diabolical schemes of all the fallen angels in the universe. We need the uncovering and the bringing into the light of all the roots of evil. Yeah, love of money. What's the love of money? The red dragon in controlling money, which is hand, through mind, which is beast. Mark of the beast and head in hand. And it's not just a microchip and guillotine like these false teachers say. It's sorcery through the brain and then the controlling through the brain of their hand to build their agenda and to warp the timelines for Satan and his sorcerers to continue to steal this universe and make it their paradise. That's exactly what's going on down here. And it's a manipulation of time. The sun and the moon and the stars are for times and seasons, it says in Ecclesiastes. And so if there's a manipulation of the sun and the moon and the stars outside of the name and the deeds and the laws of the stars, so they're disobedient to the luminaries, they're stealing the luminaries, and they've imprisoned the luminaries as one third of the angels and the wandering stars of the second heavens, then all of that through the warlocks on earth and Freemasonry and all the different secret societies of all the nations that rules all the governments right now and the economic and the whole seven mountain thing down here, all of that will rule over the Christian people. So the Christian people are going to rise up and take back the luminaries now, because that's our inheritance as children of Abraham, children of faith. Abraham was promised the stars. Isaac gave it to Jacob, and Jacob named his 12 sons after the 12 constellations in Dinah the 13th, and Rachel was the whole moon. And it's written in scripture, guys. So it means that the generations of our family tree, of our brothers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, with circumcised heart, were engrafted into the olive tree of Israel. Romans 11, it is written, we are get the inheritance of the power of the sun, the law of the greatest luminary, our sun, and the law of the moon. And the moon's light is for healing, it is written in the book of Enoch. And the four names of the moon, and the two names of the sun, and all the names of the stars, and the leader of the constellations of the stars, and the four quarters of the names of the angels that lead all the stars of the mid heavens are all there waiting for us to ascend that high in the roots of David, the seven spirits of God, through the sun gate of righteousness. And there you'll be tested at that gate to see if there is any guile in you. What are you going to use the power and the laws and the actions of the luminaries for at the gate? If there is anything corruptive in you, any selfishness in you, any love of money, you are denied entrance into higher things. Hebrews chapter 6, after all baptisms, resurrections, and teachings about the dead, God will bring you forth into a training in righteousness if and only if he permits. There's a permission needed. And it's the full testing of spirit, soul, mind, and body to use the higher powers of the law and the order of the stars and the luminaries from their courses through your spirit so that you don't practice sorcery. Because God loves you so much, he's not going to let you into these gates until you're so incorruptible in your mature spirit through Elijah and the river of life under the sun and overcome Jezebel and all the temptations of lust. and overcome all the temptations of pride of the bulls of Bashan, and all the strife with your brothers, and all the strife with your sisters, and all the jealousies of girls, and all the jealousies of boys, and all that corrupted DNA of the animal. All of that has to be completely burnt out of your spirit, soul, mind, and strife. You can't have strife in your flesh, in your DNA, even if you don't know about it. If it's there towards me as an apostolic leader, you will never be granted permission into the higher things of God. This is the guaranteed refusal and entry into these gates. You have to be perfect under the sun by the Holy Spirit, your master. Truth anyhow, you will have to be perfect in spirit to your master in your inner man, the Holy Ghost. And therefore there'll be unity of the brethren because you all have the same master. God's one Holy Spirit. God is one. There's only one spirit, it is written. Only one Holy Spirit who's the master of all of our spirits. And he is God equal to Jesus. He is God equal to the Father. Under the sun is to see how you are loyal to the one Holy Spirit who will lead you into all truth. If you are disobedient at any area of spirit, soul, mind, and body, you can forget about everything else in your life. You can self-justify. You can live down here in the realm of the dead and pretend to be okay with God, and it's not Brandon's opinion, and it's just the crazy. And you come up with all these excuses while they are wrong and you're right. And you can have your own little isolated place. Well, you won't be saved. You will lose your salvation and you go into the Dead Sea because you've sided with the Satans against the Holy Spirit, the master of all Christian born-again spirits. If you get born again and make the Holy Ghost your enemy, as many Christians do, you will not go to heaven. You're twice dead, you will go to hell, and it's written in the Word. You must be submissive and obedient and gentle and soft-hearted and soft-minded to the Holy Spirit to stay saved. No one who turns back is worthy of me, Jesus said. And the latter end of those who become twice dead is worse than the former end. It'd be better off if they had never been born. Book of Hebrews, New Testament, which is those that fight the Holy Spirit, which I deal with constantly in this Laodicean Christian church, those that fight the Holy Spirit as apostate Christians, reprobate, twice dead Christians that are nothing less than of the Balaam, of the Baal of Peor, who love the wages of wickedness, the hirelings, that are only in ministry under the throne of Satan, a false pearl, and that false bride of Christ of Heaven Awaits the Bride, who drink from the sewage of selfishness, and that whole kingdom that pretends to be the kingdom of God, they are filled with circus act clowns that pretend to be the true prophets of the shock prophetics of Ezekiel's dung heap, but are absolutely false clowns. And they have accused that of us constantly. But we're of a completely different kingdom that goes seven mountains and seven heavens high. And all the seven stars in my angel's right hand will be your judges of all of your words that you've spoken against the wise and the righteous who are not opposed to you, but opposed to Satan whom you served in your greed. In Jesus' name, they will be judged into the Dead Sea in the whole world. And there will be no forgiveness of sins for them. There be no mercy for the wicked. Amen? There is no mercy for the wicked. It is written, and vengeance is mine, says the Lord. What's the realm of vengeance? The realm of righteousness and the judgments of Enoch against the apostate Christians. And it will begin amongst the glory people, because it's the highest people, the highest level counterfeit of the second heaven's Luciferian throne of antimony. That kingdom of the three mountains of stolen gemstones, the three mountains of stolen fire, and the center mountain that is as the throne of God, but it is the throne of the red dragon Satan, and all false Christianity will be annihilated by the rigid righteousness of this Gideon's 300, of this Deborah company. This is Deborah company, amen, who wars with the luminaries, the maturity of the Shulamite warlord, Song of Solomon chapter 8, Shulamite warlord. So ladies, put on your combat boots and file down that firing pin with your M16s. There is a Tet offensive that we're bringing, not them. They've already been bringing everything they had against us since we were born. Roe versus Wade, We've already gone through the Tet Offensive on American soil. While most Christians were sleeping in religion. We've already been through it. They've already tried to kill me 300,000 times. Now, we're in a place where we can kill them with righteousness. We can kill them with the breastplate of judgment. We can enforce the angelic order of righteousness, Melchizedek, that annihilates the king of Sodom, whose name in Hebrew means wickedness. That's the devil, people. That's the pleasures of Satan and the stealing of the universe from our brother and sister, Adam and Eve, who intercede for us constantly. Amen. To take back what they lost, which was dominion in the heavens and dominion in the earth and dominion over all the animals and over all flesh and blood, dominion over the stars and the sun and the moon and their names and their laws and their deeds. Dominion in the universe. Righteousness has dominion. Wisdom has dominion. Holiness and the purity of the virgin sons of God rising from the realm of the dead, the realm of all perversion, earth, if you're on it, you're perverted, into the realm of all purity above the sun, where there's no perversion, because you have all of the light of God's names judging your DNA, judging your heart, judging your mind, cleansing you. That's the realm of Job in the Old Testament being a perfect man. Why? Because if you read Job, he had all those constellations passing through him, judging him with the luminaries' laws. Job was pre-flood. Job was a righteous man that lived in Pangaea before the flood of the breaking up of the seven continents of planet Earth. Job practiced righteousness. The scriptures say Job was perfect, and he was completely fortified that the highest ranking Satan couldn't touch him in his family, in his finances, in his businesses, in his marketplace, and he was the richest man in the world. Why? Because of the constellations before the 12 tribes were named the constellations, later, 1,000 years later, but Job had them going through his spirit. He was holding them for the 12 tribes of Israel. True. And he was faithful with them, totally faithful. Even when he was handed over to Satan to be tested, could Job be this great? Job was that great. And you can be that great too by practicing the stars through your spirit and their names and their actions and their deeds, and get every other wandering star out of you and let it burn up your heart and your mind and your DNA and your bones and marrow and clean you up and turn you clear. What color is the sun? Google it. White. White. The white throne judgment seat of Christ. Those that embrace the judgment of the perfect DNA of the sun and the moon and the stars. The moon's light is for healing, and the moon will shine like the sun, and the earth will shine as the sun. These are all scriptures now. Don't look at me like that. The earth will go back into stardom when we begin to practice righteousness. All the lights of the two-thirds stars that orbit in their courses, and their names, their actions, their laws, will go right through our spirit, and then all their splendor, like 7 volts, will come up through your little tiny heart, your little tiny brain, your little tiny bone down here, your little temple, and it'll pour it out in the radiance of all the glory of the mid-heavens. And so it'll heal all DNA on earth. But it'll be a righteous judgment upon Cain's DNA. And Cain's selfish, religious, diabolical DNA will be terminated in all the earth. And there will be no more sinners on earth. It is written, for they shall all know the Lord. And the earth will be as heaven, what does the Bible say? Pray that it be on earth as it is in heaven. Well, it's the fulfillment of Enoch. It's a direct reference of the Lord's Prayer, on earth as it is in heaven, is written, and Jesus knew this like scripture and taught it to his disciples, of what Enoch prophesied thousands of years before Jesus came in the flesh, when he was still the angel of the Lord, because Enoch and the angel of the Lord were close friends. Enoch wrote thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of years before the New Testament, John's revelation, that I saw one as the head of days, who had hair like lamb's white wool and eyes of flashing fire. What? And his appearance was so great that I died in his presence. That's what Enoch says, but he wasn't dead, just raptured. Some of you need the rapture of death. Then you won't have any fears in you. There's a rapture of death. What does that mean? Where the light of the Lamb of God who's conquered death at Calvary burns all the death contracts out of your cells, out of your bloodlines, out of your souls, right through your heart and right through your brain. So the demonic influence of the false kingdom of heaven and the seven mountains of the Satans can't penetrate your DNA and manipulate your five senses, your brain, or your heart and lead you astray again. Like Azazel sent out into the wilderness. That's where these people go. They go with Azazel, the goat nature of pride. The chief Satan, to him be ascribed all sin, it is written. And Moses copied the entire law of the Pentateuch after the book of Enoch, if you read it. How authoritative is Enoch? Authoritative enough to write Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Deuteronomy, and Numbers. Does that do anything for you? Hopefully. In Jesus' name. Well, we just got a couple more hours here. 2,300 verses from Enoch about law and order. You ready? Oh, yeah, we already brought them all. Thank you. Enoch, chapter 2, verse 1. I observed everything that took place in the heavens, how the luminaries which are in the heavens do not depart from their paths, that each one rises and sets in order, each in its time, and they do not depart from their laws. Whoa! So there's nothing more rock solid than the name of the Word of God, of the sun and the stars. And if your spirit, soul, mind, and body are based on them, you'll overcome death. You'll conquer and change everyone around you, no matter how sinful they are. Enoch 7:4, and the giants turned themselves against mankind in order to devour them. Enoch 11:1, and in those days they will open the storerooms of blessings which are in heaven in order to bring them down upon the earth, upon the deeds and labor of the children of men. Enoch 22:9, and he answered and said to me, these three apartments are made in order to separate the souls of the dead. What is it? Gehenna, Hades, Tartarus. And thus are the souls of the just separated. What's the souls of the just separated? Outer court, inner court, holy place. And there is a spring of water above and light for the souls of the justice. For the souls of the just. Amen. What's the difference? Living water? None. Dry place. Egypt. Enoch 56:5. And in those days the angels assemble and turn their heads towards the east, towards the people of Parthia and Media, Twitter, in order to excite the kings, and that a spirit of disturbance come over them and disturb them from off their thrones, that they come forth from their resting places like lions now, and like hungry wolves amidst their flocks. Jesus Christ, direct quote from Enoch, written thousands of years before his words. If you study it, Jesus quotes Enoch constantly. You could say when the Messiah came down here, the scroll of Enoch was the main influence for the fulfilling of his messianic calling. Right? Truth in you. Enoch 66:1. And after that he showed me the angels of punishment who are prepared to come in order to open all the powers of the water which is under the earth, that it may be a judgment and destruction over all those who live and dwell on the earth. Enoch 72:5. The wagons, the chariots, on which he ascends are driven by the wind, and the sun descending disappears from the heavens and returns through the north in order to reach the east, and is led that he comes to that portal and shines on the surface of heaven. Enoch 74:9. Thus I saw their places, the sun rising and setting according to the order of their months. Times and seasons and the timeline of God is the order of the sun, the moon, and all the stars through your righteous spirits. That's how you stay in God's timeline. That's how you don't get pulled off into sorcery. It's the order of God's timing. It's the order of righteousness. Enoch 79, verse 2. And he showed me all their laws for every day, for every time, and for every government, and for every year, and her departure, according to her order, in each month and in every week. Enoch 80, verse 4. And the moon will change her order and will not appear in her time. Enoch 80, verse 5. And in those days it will be seen on the heavens that a great unfruitfulness will come on the outermost chariot in the west, and she will shine more brightly than according to the order of light. Now the sinner's manipulation of luminaries. You can manipulate moon magic, sun magic, star magic. That's what all sorcery is. And if a nation and a destiny and a calling is not according to the law and the names and the deeds of God the Father through the reflection of the suns and the stars, through their spirit, and it's a soulish, selfish thing to the Satans that fell from heaven, there's a corruption of the heavenlies. So since God has irrevocably given the sun and the moon and the stars to the Jewish race, and they've used it mostly for central banking systems and governments and to do something against Christ, which is Freemasonry, the killing of the King of the Jews, which is a Jewish sorcery. It's training in Jewish sorcery. Freemasonry is training in Jewish sorcery. And it's what plagues all nations right now. It's what plagues the CIA, the FBI. It's what plagues the police departments and all the corruption in police and the IRS and the governments and the city, state, county, federal level, all 16 branches, Pentagon, Pentagram, and Washington, D.C., New York City. And all of it is because of Jewish sorcery. Beware of them who say they are Jews but are not, but are a synagogue of Satan. Jesus Christ, red letters, Revelation. It is written. It's about the irrevocable gifts of the luminaries used by the Jewish race, and they taught all the Gentile sorcery. Right? Truth, anyhow. So now you're going up against all that's established before you, hundreds and hundreds of years of the mastery of the magic arts. And we come in here with like Pentecostalism and think we're going to make a dent in it. You will have to practice Enoch's level of righteousness to even make a dent. And so we need that level of teaching. We need that level of preaching. That's why God has raised up Red Letter Ministries. That's our function and purpose during these days, to train your spirit in such a way that you can actually effectively combat ancient sorcery of the ancient primal evil of the red dragon and all the sorcery of the sorcerers in all nations, tribes, and tongues that oppresses them, that murders their children, that gets them addicted to drugs and alcohol on purpose. Whoa. Drugs and alcohol are introduced on purpose by governments to pacify you. Crack cocaine was introduced by the CIA into Watts, Los Angeles in the 60s on purpose. Everyone knows that in Los Angeles. It's fact. I've seen the manipulation. I have dealt with the Scottish Rite warlock who even tried to put me on heroin when I'm a full-time minister. So the sorcerers out there are saying to all their dogs, when is he going to relapse? It's not even a temptation for me. But since they're faithless, like their fathers, the Satans, they can't have a grid for practicing righteousness, and they can't see into the development of light of the seven spirits of God in the inner man. That's why they're always astonished. Ezekiel 28, they'll be astonished looking at Lucifer's destruction because they thought there was something there because it's so real in the natural realm. Witchcraft is so real. Human DNA is real, corrupted, and controllable by the perversion of light of the second heavens. So they're astonished because of their unbelief that someone would practice uprightness of heart and scorn the temptations of all sexual morality and lust. They have no grid for purity, people. 200 million demons can't even imagine purity, nor can they, because they're demons. So when you're around demons, you have no grid for purity. When you're around holy, innocent, seven stars, seven archangels breathing on you, you have a grid for purity. Purity becomes normal. Impurity becomes vile and disgusting, and you want it judged as quick as possible from your midst, in your cities, in your nations, in your governments. And all the kingdom of hell is exposed. And we're going to get some scraps off our table to these Ishmaels out here. That'll be like, you'll look at these people doing our works and say, wow, I got to support Donald Trump and Elon Musk now. And the Republicans. But it's the sons of God, people, doing all the works. You need to support Red Letter Ministries, the source and the head of all the freedom going on here in the entire universe, in the entire world. Truth anyhow, and anyone that likes us, any other ministry that likes us and is not in competition and strife towards us, will be greatly blessed by our righteous leadership and our holy leadership during these days. I've lived my life on camera since 2009 on purpose. For people to be able to trust the consistency in the prophetic. The immaturity out there is so bad that they can't even understand half of it from 2009. But now the maturity will be so apparent, burning into your eye sockets, that you'll be able to trust your righteous leadership, trust your holy prophetic leadership, your apostolic leadership, that will raise up 144 apostles like me, after me, like Rebecca, after her, and you will see it before your eyes, kingdom government of the sons of God, predestined, foreordained, all the prophecies of Bob Jones fulfilled before your eyes. Many will not like it because they wanted it for themselves, but they were soulish, so you're disqualified. Go into the spirit and get qualified. Go the same path we went through, and get qualified in the seven eyes of the Holy Spirit and stop self-qualifying yourselves. Stop going and getting your certificates from man as if God cares about that. Stop anointing your own souls with the second heavens of the wandering stars. And purchase eye salve and purchase oil that your wicks be trimmed and your lamps be full of oil. And your hearts be circumcised, your souls be circumcised, and there be nothing false in you against God the Father's righteous leadership that the sons and daughters of the living God are beginning to demonstrate at a cosmic righteous level of Enoch during these days. Amen. Then you too can get into the government of God, be under divine government, be under white dove government, be under righteousness and holiness and the government of the Word of God without your animal DNA opposing God the Father, and you too can partake of the blessing of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and not be opposed to it in your hearts, but be married to Jesus in your hearts, the King of the Jews, and the cross of his blood, and the cup of his everlasting covenant, without your additions or opinions, but the opinions of God the Father and his archangels influencing your brains. You've been under the influence of Satan's principalities, big time. Now you're going to be under the influence of God the Father's principalities in your brains, big time. When your brain is under the influence of holy principalities. Now the fallen angels, many of the leaders, came from the order of principalities. You know who the head of that order is? Michael, the honored, the head of the order of principalities, the chief warring angel of the King of Israel. And he serves directly with me every day since I started this ministry. Truth anyhow. Otherwise, there would be zero chance I could have survived. This ministry is leading with seven archangels of the Watchers of the Mid-Heavens from the beginning. And only now the words and the teachings and the descriptions have come forth from the experiences of decades in the anointing against all the enemies of Christ in the earth and in the heavenlies and under the earth, so that you can get into angelic order where your spirit is and find your rank and your class, upgrade your armor, upgrade your armory, upgrade your arsenal, upgrade your ammunition, upgrade your life, upgrade your heart and your mind angelically, DNA of the stars and their order, and have a different manifestation through those same bodies that are ever changing by the word of God. Changing by the word of God. Everything in you must change in order to keep growing. If you stop changing, you start dying. If you continue changing and love the changing of Christian metamorphosis, Romans 12:2, this will be fun for you. This will be the adventure of a lifetime, the meaning of life, what you've been looking for, the fulfillment, the depth of all the things of God, meaning, adventure, thrill, the thrill of the fight, the eye of the tiger, running the race to win the prize of the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus, finding what you are as a spirit, and then developing and leveling up your spirit in angelic ability that works on the street level, so it's not just in fantasy video games, but your life is a real video game and you're becoming aware of yourself as a game master. And you're seeing Earth restored to her original beauty. Amen. And you can climb the mountaintops with Gideon and Deborah and Samson and all the judges, Joshua and Caleb, and take the high places in your lives right now by the Holy Spirit and your submission to the seven spirits of God in your hearts. And then come into Joel's bar and being around prophets be easier for you, because you're always submitted to the prophet Jesus in the secret place 24/7, 365. And this will just be like a feast instead of like confrontational. And you come in here with all the victories of your obediences and yieldedness to the master of God's sevenfold Holy Spirit, the messianic anointing, Jesus in you. The Lord Jesus is in you fully, completely, and totally by the seven spirits of God. That's what the Bible says. Revelation chapter 5, verse 6. And I saw a lamb looking as though it had been slain, having seven eyes and seven horns, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all brains. Earth, which is brains. Will you receive seven horns and seven eyes into your brains and just be burnt up from self and never think about yourself, only think about the seven spirits of God and God's self, so that the glory of God and his presence and his purity can be practiced within your souls? And as you practice the seven spirits of God in your soul becomes a soul of God, which is a son of God, and you can't think a demonic, selfish thought about you ever again. It's not possible. It's called the mind of Christ, which means there's no mind of you, only the mind of Christ, the thoughts of Christ, the thoughts of the Father are the only things that pass through your brain constantly. So everything you do and say is perfect all the time. And that is the mind of Christ where you are going. Let all of your brains be penetrated by the seven spirits of God, the horns and the eyes of the messianic anointing, the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, and the spirit of the Lord pierce through your brains and your skulls and turn them white with a new name written on it, Jesus Christ, heavenly Jerusalem, and God the Father. Mark your foreheads tonight. Take a seal, take a mark. Let the seven stars breathe upon your souls. You need all the help you can get. We're for you, not against you. So you can get as charged up as you want and desire from God the Father here tonight as you can receive. And there's a whole lot more. Some of you, as you mature, you can come back to this and get recharged, because you could only receive so little because you had so much pride in you. Later on, as you get emptied of self and you cry, your pride out and just mourn and weep how you've been a murderer of Jesus against the apostles and prophets. And there will be a mourning and a weeping and a sorrow that you are his murderers. You Christians are his murderers. And you'll be forgiven as all that pride and all that Pharisee seed comes out of your souls and out of your minds and out of your eyes and out of your senses. There will be mourning. There will be weeping and there will be forgiveness as you mourn and weep and are forgiven all of your murders against the apostles of your generation in Jesus' name. And then you'll be filled and penetrated by the seven spirits of God. Then you wear a crown of anointing that you know you didn't deserve. Because you've killed him, you've murdered him, and you fought him, and you opposed his prophets, you opposed his apostles. You have not been his friend. You have been his enemy in your minds. And now your mind is washed. Now your mind is healed. Now your mind is his mind. So you are one in mind, in thought, brain, and deed, in hand. So that all your temple is used for God's kingdom building and never your own ever again. You are the bride of the Lamb, and we bless you in Jesus' name. Have a great night, and we'll see you tomorrow in a greater glory. Amen. If you'd like to give an offering, there's links in the description. If you'd like to start tithing from your businesses, it's a great opportunity to show and reveal in your hearts where you're disloyal to the kingdom, where you're still soulish and building your own kingdom, where you're still working for your own house and not the house of the Father, which is all perishable. It's all stuff that will fade away. Anything that's not done for God, by God, with your head in your hand, will burn and die and will go into the Dead Sea. So right now, you can repent with all of your spirit, soul, mind, and house, with all of your mind and your hand, and all of your marketplace and the ability to accrue wealth in the earth, in this covenant of wealth. Use it for God's kingdom, God's house. And if you are a blessing to God's kingdom and God's house, the Bible teaches that God will then, after you supplying his house, he will bless your house. But if you are selfish in your house, withholding in your house, you'll be utterly destroyed into the Dead Sea with Satan and his angels and his three stolen mountains of gemstones that he's stolen from Christ's righteousness. Because the judgment coming in these days will return the fortunes of King David, Zion. They will return the fortunes of Abraham to ones exactly like Abraham in righteousness and in holiness, at the same level of maturity if he had still continued living on the earth and is now 4,000 years old. Those are the ones who will manage the government of God from the mid-heavens, ruling from the angelic sphere as angels above the sun with all the laws of the luminaries under their spirit. Revelation 5:10, it is written for 1,000 years. Your reaction to this teaching, your heart and your mind to this teaching, will determine your eternal fate and seal you in Satan's kingdom or Jesus Christ. I bless your spirit with grace to choose Jesus Christ and his kingdom, and the grace of the Lord Jesus help you to obey with all of your heart and mind and hand today for God the Father's good pleasure in his house and his kingdom in Jesus' name. Amen.
The first voice blesses the Lord of spirits forever and ever. And the second voice I heard blessing the elect one and the elect ones who hang upon the Lord of spirits. And the third voice I heard pray and intercede for those who dwell on the earth and supplicate in the name of the Lord of spirits. And I heard the fourth voice fending off the Satans and forbidding them to come before the Lord of Spirits to accuse them who dwell on the earth. After that I asked the angel of peace who went with me, who showed me everything that is hidden, "Who are these four presences which I have seen, and whose words I have heard and written down?" And he said to me, "The first is Michael, the merciful and long-suffering, and the second, who is set over all the diseases and all the wounds of the children of men, is Raphael, and the third, who is set over all the powers, is Gabriel, and the fourth, who is set over the repentance unto hope of those who inherit eternal life, is named Phanuel. And these are the four angels of the Lord of Spirits, and the four voices I heard in those days."